Hi! Today we're going to talk about gadolinium and the blood-brain barrier. So how does gadolinium produce enhancement on MRI? To answer this, let's first follow the story of the red blood cell and the neuron here. The neuron here being a queen, having lots of oxygen needs. The red blood cell here needs to travel a bit. From the larger to the medium-sized arteries, to the cortical arteries, and it penetrates the cortex. Now in the arterioles, the caliber here becomes smaller. Now take a look at these capillaries, which are highlighted in yellow. Within these capillaries, the RBCs would then line up, just like this. Okay? Now look at these capillary walls here. This capillary walls would have this endothelium, and this endothelium have tight endothelial cell junctions. In addition, these walls are guarded by this astrocyte foot processes. So these tight junctions of the endothelium plus the astrocyte foot processes here can be likened to security guards of the brain. By this, I mean the bad things within the blood vessels are not able to simply enter the brain. This is what we call the blood-brain barrier. So, will the oxygen carried by the red blood cells be able to access or allowed entry into the brain or into the interstitium, then the neuron? Yes, of course, because the neuron will need that. Oxygen and lipid-soluble substances are allowed passage. What about water? Yes, also, they are allowed entry or passage. But what about gadolinium? Gadolinium here is drawn in white circles. If the blood-brain barrier here is intact, okay, the gadolinium will not be able to enter the interstitium. Okay? The gadolinium here will not be able to get close to the neuron. Okay? Gadolinium does not enter the normal blood-brain barrier. So again, tight junctions mean a barrier, and this tight junction is seen in the arachnoid layer. Intact tight junctions plus intact astrocyte foot processes means no entry for the gadolinium into the interstitium. Now, what if the capillaries are diseased, just like this? Gadolinium will now be able to enter the interstitium. Will this gadolinium be able to enter the neuron here and become intracellular? The answer is no. The gadolinium stays extracellular here. And what do we have here in the extracellular space or the interstitium? You have water there. Water here is scribbled in blue. Gadolinium will then exert an effect on this interstitial water, making the T1 relaxation time short. And what does it mean when we have T1 shortening? It means we're going to have a bright signal on T1 weighted images. Take a look at this example. This one is the pre-contrast, this one is the post-contrast study. The periphery of the lesion here shows definite enhancement. Lesson learned here is that gadolinium is an extracellular contrast, meaning it stays in the interstitium. It shortens the relaxation time of water there, hence creating enhancement. In the normal brain and areas of intact blood-brain barrier, the capillaries are impermeable to intravascularly injected contrast agents. In areas where there is no blood-brain barrier, there will be enhancement. Okay? This is normally found in the following structures, which include your pituitary gland and the pineal gland. Okay, so there is normal post-contrast enhancement in these structures. Now, what common condition would have leaky capillaries? And when we have leaky capillaries, this will allow entry of gadolinium to the interstitium. A good example would be tumors from outside the brain, such as metastasis. What about tumors originating within the brain, just like gliomas? If their capillaries are still CNS-like, then it will have an intact blood-brain barrier. And we have that, and when we have that, there will be no enhancement. However, if the capillaries are fenestrated, such as in malignant gliomas, there will be a broken blood-brain barrier. Thus, that lesion would enhance. How about extra-axial tumors like meningiomas? Meningiomas originate from the arachnoid cap cells, right? And these tumors would have capillaries which do not have tight cell endothelial cell junctions. Therefore, if they lack tight junctions, these tumors will then enhance avidity. Now, going back to our story here, gadolinium traveling with the red blood cells here within the vessels may or may not gain entry into the interstitium. And the interstitium, again, is the space in between the cells in the brain. And this entry or non-entry would be dependent on the status of the blood-brain barrier. And this blood-brain barrier comes from the tight endothelial cell junctions, and it's guarded also by the astrocyte foot processes. Okay, I thank you for your time for listening, and I hope to see you again soon.